So now, I will introduce Dr. Rafif Ziyada, who will be sharing with us her stories, her resilience, her telling the world that yes, us Palestinians, we are here, and no matter what these Zionists do, no matter how they try to erase our narrative, we will remain here forever. Dr. Rafif Ziyada is a Palestinian performance poet and a human rights activist based in London. She's performed several poems, and I'm sure you guys know of the famous one, "We Teach Life, Sir." She also received an Ontario Arts Council grant from the Word of Mouth program to create her debut spoken word album, Hadil. She was chosen to represent Palestine at the South Bank Center Poets Olympiad in 2012. Dr. Ziyad's debut album, Hadil, is dedicated to Palestinian youth who still fly kites in the face of F-16 bombers, who still remember the names of their villages in Palestine and still hear the sound of Hadil over Gaza. Please give Dr. Rafif Ziyada a warm Chicago welcome.
Good evening, and thank you everybody for being here. And once again, thanks to Medical Aid for Palestinians for all the work that they do. And thanks a million times specifically to the organization hosting all of us here, American Muslims for Palestine, for this exceptionally wonderful conference. I think a big round of applause goes to you, all the organizers. That was a very, very tough act to follow. And if Mads Gilbert is still in the room, if Doctor, you're still in the room, I don't want to say thank you, because you don't thank your own family. You don't thank your father, you don't thank your brother, you don't thank your uncle. But I think it's most fitting that I begin with this poem that I wrote during this latest assault, and it really breaks my heart that now I have to number my poems by the number of assaults. But during this latest attack, I got a video from a friend in Gaza who said, "Rafif, please write something, look at what's happening." And he sent me this extremely graphic video and said, "You need to tell the world what's happening." And I could only come up with these words. I should say something about spoken word before I begin. The beauty of spoken word and why I do it is that it's all about the audience. It's all about connecting with you. So if you hear something you like, make sure to make a noise. You can click, clap, or smile, but it's quite intimidating in this room, and this podium is very scary. So let's pretend we're in a Palestinian refugee camp a little bit. If my words can stop this, if my words can stop this, if my words can stand in the way of a bomb, a bullet, or a single drone, I would lay them at the feet of every child in Gaza. I would offer them like prayer and recite them over and over and over like the holy names of God. I would write them endlessly until all language breaks. Like daylight breaks as we count our dead, they ask me for balance. He used to balance his son on his knees and sing, and now he's lost his legs and his son. How can I balance your silence against the sound of artillery in Gaza? How can I balance your silence against neighborhoods wiped out into smoke? How can I balance between David and Goliath? Shh, we're not meant to make these kinds of comparisons. They make some people uncomfortable. So let me just tell you, we're still standing here. We are holding our ground. We are still standing here. We are holding our ground. If my words can stop this, I would scream back this gasoline taste in my throat for 4 weeks now. I would write my spine disfigured like maps of Palestine and stand tall, and the top of my lungs scream, "Make them stop, make them stop, make them stop, please, someone make them stop. They are just children playing. Is the beach forbidden? Is there any place safe under your sky made of iron dome?" But we are holding our ground. We are holding our ground. I promise you, we are holding our ground. If my words can stop this, I would argue circles around every Israeli spokesperson and tell them, let's be clear. Your smooth accents can't make killing children justified. Let's be clear, we are not collateral. Don't you dare call me collateral. Let's be clear. Your polished talking points stick inside bone, near skin, like shrapnel. Let's be clear, Mark Regev, there's no excuse you can come up with, so please, please, spare us and shut up. If my words can stop this, if my words can stop this, I would hold them up like fists pounding, like hearts pounding in shelters. They asked us to evacuate, and then they bombed us. And he pressed her little head into his chest. She's alive, I swear, she's alive. They had to pry her little body out of his hands, and if I could, I would offer me his daughter. If I could, I would say words to wipe out all this pain, but the sky is raining heavy steel everywhere. This is no time for poetry. There is no space for bodies in hospitals anymore. There's no water, there's no electricity. Do you understand me? Can you hear me? In this darkness, I wish words can transform to light, to protection. And I so wish for some quiet. I so wish for some quiet for those who battle to get to the microphones and perform their rituals. All you clamoring to get on stages to speak your rage, spare us. Get out of the limelight, let Gaza speak, let Rafah speak, let Jenin speak, let Jerusalem speak, let Shatila speak, let Deir Yassin speak, let everybody. Let everybody lying on the streets of Gaza speak for itself today. I will not mourn my dead in 140 characters for Twitter. My dead are not your Facebook status. My dead will not be cluttered into an infographic that you share today and then forget. We are holding our ground. We are holding our ground. We are holding our ground. And if my words can stop this, I would create a rhythm louder than this beat, too familiar. I would learn the lyrics to every freedom song, and I would write them on every building still standing in Gaza. If my words can stop this, if they can stand in the way of a single bomb, drone, or bullet, I would lay them at the feet of every child in Gaza. I would offer them like prayer. I would recite them over and over and over and over like the holy names of God. But words can't stop this. So I offer you my silence. I offer you a poem for Gaza. We've had a pretty depressing night, so I'm gonna try to liven it up a little bit. I should also explain that it's 5 a.m. in my body and mind at the moment, coming from London. So I'm doing pretty well for 5 a.m, no? Thank you. This poem is called Savage Terrorist. I lived in Canada for a very long time, and I did quite a little bit of indigenous solidarity while I was there, because I think we Palestinians need to stand for justice wherever we are and stand with the oppressed wherever we are. But one day we were at this indigenous blockade, and one of the women told me, oh, it's the same thing, they used to call us savages and now they call you terrorists. So I wrote this poem in her honor. Tonight, I make no apologies, I make no apologies, I make no apologies. Tonight, I make no apologies. I am what I am, indigenous from Palestine, and tonight, I make no apologies. I am what I am, indigenous from Palestine, and I am your savage, your terrorist. Demographic threat, born to a demographic threat, and we'll give you your next demographic threat, rapper in a hatta. Rapper in a hatta, and name my baby girl Yafa. I am your savage, your terrorist. My mother rubbed olive oil on my hair and in my skin until the smell of Palestine seeped through to my veins. I have an immune system. I have an immune system you can only dream of, build on anarwa, hummus, and fool. And they tell me you're Polish. They tell me you're Polish or Russian and that some god promised you my land. Can I have a phone, a fax number, an email for your god? I'd like to have a chit-chat. Don't know. I don't know when God became a real estate agent and started promising away other people's land. I mean, manifest destiny. Are you seriously looking me in the eye in this century and still talking about manifest destiny? I am your savage, your terrorist, and can't you see? Can't you see every rock in Jerusalem knows my last name? And every wave hitting the Haifa shore is waiting for me to return. And I will return. And I will always be on your mind. I will always be on your mind in the cactus plants and the stones of your homes. I will always be on your mind, always there to haunt you, always there to haunt you. Yours, yours, your savage, your terrorist. Thank you. All right. Now this is feeling like a Palestinian room. How many people have heard the poem Arab Woman of Color? All right. So I wrote this poem when we were doing a direct creative action on my university campus. We build a mock apartheid wall, and we were pretending that it was a checkpoint. I, being very petty at the time, said I refuse to be an Israeli soldier. I will only be a Palestinian citizen, which meant that I had to throw a bunch of red paint on myself and lie on the ground, which then made me a very easy target for a young Zionist. Yeah. Bad word that I shouldn't say, to actually kick me in the stomach and say, you deserve to be raped before you have your terrorist children. I haven't had the time to work on the terrorist children, but I've quite worked on this poem, so I hope you like it. اسمحوا لي أن أتكلم بلساني العربي قبل أن يحتلوا لغتي أيضاً. Allow me to speak my Arab tongue before they occupy my language as well. Allow me to speak my mother tongue so her words can come through me before they occupy her memory as well. I am an Arab woman of color, and we come in all shades of anger. All my grandfather ever wanted to do was wake up at dawn and watch my grandmother kneel and pray in a village hidden between Yaffa and Haifa. My mother was born under an olive tree on a soil they say is no longer mine, but I will cross their barriers, their checkpoints, their damn apartheid walls, and I'll return to my homeland. I am an Arab woman of color, and we come in all shades of anger. And did you hear my sister screaming yesterday with Israeli soldiers looking between her legs for their next demographic threat? She called her baby girl Janine. And did you hear Amne Muna screaming behind their prison bars as they tear gassed her cell? We are returning to Palestine. I am an Arab woman of color, and we come in all shades of anger. But you tell me this womb inside of me will only bring you your next terrorist, beard-wearing, gun-waving, towel-head sand nigger. You tell me I send my children out to die, but those are your copters, your F-16s, in our skies. And let's talk about this terrorism business for a second. Wasn't it the CIA that killed Alende and Lumumba? and who trained Osama in the first place. My grandparents didn't run around like clowns with white capes and white hoods on their heads lynching black people. So let me break it to you. There is no good occupation and no moral army. I am an Arab woman of color, and we come in all shades of anger. So who's that brown woman screaming in a demonstration? Sorry, should I not scream? Did I forget to be your every Orientalist dream? Genie in a bottle, belly dancer, harem girl, soft-spoken Arab woman? Yes, master. No, master. Thank you for the peanut butter sandwiches raining down on us from your B-52s, master. Yes, my liberators are here to kill my children and call them collateral damage. I am an Arab woman of color, and we come in all shades of anger. So let me just tell you, this woman side of me will only bring you your next rebel. She'll have a rock. This woman side of me will only bring you your next rebel. She'll have a rock in one hand and a Palestinian flag in the other. I am an Arab woman of color. Beware, beware, beware our anger. Thank you.
Oh no, I only have 5 minutes left and like 60 poems to do.
I promised Aya. I want to give a huge, huge round of applause to all my sisters at this conference. And just so all my brothers are not upset, a huge round of applause to all the brothers at the conference as well. The most beautiful thing to me about being at this conference and being here with American Muslims for Palestine has been that I felt the hospitality of home. I could have been walking in Tell al-Za'atar or Shatila or Burj al-Barajni or any refugee camp. So thank you all so much for your generous hospitality. I felt like we were in Palestine. I think I'll do sieges. This is a poem about sieges. Your sieges beat into our bones, freedom songs. Your sieges beat into our bones, freedom songs. We recite them in bread lines, in visa lines, in these lines, I repeat them. We stomp into this earth to remember we are alive. It holds our feet steady towards home. We are from here. We've always been here. We are from here. We've always been here. Brown like this earth. You want to bury us in, expel us from this rubble. This rubble you walk through, soldier, is memory on our skin. This rubble you walk through, soldier, is memory on our skin. Because home is not walls and stones. It is heartbeats gathered to make sure that no one goes to bed hungry. Mothers make sure that even by candlelight, children study. And that grandmother who told me that if I'm ever going to get a husband and learn how to bake, I need to add rose water to everything. Even a Molotov. Your sieges beat into our bones, freedom songs, and this rubble you walk through, soldier, is memory on our skin, and you can't erase that. On ancestors' tongues hung in the public streets of Akka, who know too well where trails of tears lead. They know too well the feel of needles piercing native tongue. They know too well small boats that are too small to pack history. For them, I will recite the name of the first village you destroyed. For them, I will recite the name of the last village you destroyed and the 500 in between. For them, I will recite the name of the first village you destroyed. For them, I will recite the name of the last village you destroyed and 500 in between. I will repeat them over and over and over until one day I meet you on the shore of Haifa, free. Can I do two more only? Yeah. Yeah. Is that okay with everyone? Yeah. I'm gonna do it anyway. I'm gonna direct action it like Palestinians, and no one will be able to take me. I just want to do Breathe, and then I'll do Teach Life, because I've promised so many people I'll do it. But the reason I want to do Breathe is because my entire first CD, Hadil, was a collection of stories of Palestinian girls. They were collections from my youth and my childhood, and then a lot of stories of Palestinian girls from Gaza. The CD, by the way, I will get it and put it on the AMP table, and if you'd like to buy it, please do. All of the money goes to actually Palestinian families that are fleeing Yarmouk refugee camp and are stuck in Greece. And I know we've spoken about Gaza quite a lot this weekend, but I want to specifically say that my poem was We Palestinians Teach Life, because a Palestinian is a Palestinian is a Palestinian no matter where we are. And I know that Gaza is the one suffering and hurting the most, but from the Naqab all the way to our refugee camps in Lebanon, to our refugee camps in Syria, our Palestinian people have always been one, so let's not let the Zionists divide us into many nations. This poem is called Breathe, and it's for the little girl that lost her family on the beach in Gaza. You saw a lot of the images on television when it first happened, and she was just running around crying. This is quite a heavy poem, and I always give a disclaimer that if I break down or you break down, I promise you a hug for free at the end of it. Breathe. Push breath in, breathe so deep. Push breath in, breathe so deep, but air won't come into lungs. Push breath in, breathe so deep, but air won't come into lungs, because lungs are too filled with sorrow. Lungs are filled with too much sorrow. She breaks and folds her bones compact to take up as little space as possible, to hide unnoticed, silent. She takes up as little space as possible to hide unnoticed silence until the silence breaks through her bones, breaks through with a loud howl, Yamma. Wainak Yamma? But it's too late. It's too late. Like Palestine, she breaks every 10 seconds, waiting by the phone with the bombs, with the news blaring, blasting, blaring through bombs over Gaza. Like Palestine, she screams deep in the sand, no one killed them. Bury her head in the sand, down there no one died, down there no one died. But record, take your pictures. You have always recorded and you have always taken your pictures. So we are not your statistics. We are not your statistics, yeah. Yaba, shuf shu amlu fina, yaba. Push breath in, push breath in, breathe so deep. She holds tight and whispers chants on wide streets. But no matter what shoes are on, the feel is still refugee, barefoot. And she hugs every person like it's her last sense of her own hands on someone else's back. And she hugs every person like it's her last sense of her own hands on someone else's back. Push breath in, breathe so deep, but air won't come into lungs. Lungs are filled with too much sorrow. Sorrow like charcoal body parts. Sorrow like childbirth in reverse. Sorrow like I can't identify body parts and I stare at flesh. Olive brown, just like mine. Breathe, breathe, if I can just breathe. But lungs are filled with too much sorrow. Sorrow like charcoal body parts. Sorrow like childbirth in reverse. Push breath in, breathe so deep. And some days she still hugs every person like it's her last sense of her own hands on someone else's back. Because some days she still smells her own flesh just to make sure it's not burning, to make sure that you're all still alive. Breathe, breathe. Sure. I've been told that we are going to save. Does this mean I can't do Hadil? No, I heard a big no. Which I have to what? I'm going to let the chair take over.
I know we all want Dr. Afif Ziada to go on and on, but we're saving the poem We Teach Life, Sir, for tomorrow's entertainment night at 8:15 p.m., so be sure you're there. All right.
Can I do Hadil then to finish? All right, so we are saving Teach Life, so I'll do Hadil instead, the title of my first CD, and then we could end on that note. Which one? Oh, so I shouldn't do any today?
I don't know. إيش بدكم مش عارفة.
Hadil is 9. Hadil is 9. I'm sorry. I apologize. I always make this mistake. Hadil was 9. An official said, Israeli officials said that they regret her death, but rockets must stop, terror must stop, resistance must stop, rockets must stop, terror must stop, resistance must stop, or they will continue, they will continue, they will continue to shell Gaza until we surrender the bit of dignity we have left, until we elect who they want, sign what they want, and die in silence the way they want. You see, Israeli security is absolute. It's written in blood and bulldozers and the art of women spokespersons. Because death is softer coming from a woman. Death is more polite, they tell me, coming from a woman. But who will tell Hadil's mother, busy baking bread and za'atar, that the doves will not fly over Gaza again? The doves will not fly over Gaza again. The doves will not fly over Gaza again. Hadil is gone. And her brother Ahmed lost his sight. Hadil. Hadil, every prayer I remember and half remember won't bring you back. As you wrap yourself in stories of Palestine, waiting a while for the next soldier to knock down your door, but the Gaza sky still rains US-made shells. The Gaza sky still rains US-made shells to cast us out of a history we carry on our back. And who will tell Hadil's mother that nothing changed the day Hadil died? Nothing stopped. Not a pause, not a tear, next meeting, next cigarette, next train, check email and sigh over another Palestinian gone. Solidarity from afar, like a sick joke, a bad story to tell a child. But the doves will not fly over Gaza again. The doves will not fly over Gaza again. And they tell me, they've always taught me, don't cry for martyrs. Don't waste time crying for martyrs. Carry on the fight, 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 carry on the fight. But for Hadil, give me a moment of silence. No, I apologize. I always make this mistake. Give me a moment of resistance. A moment of sincere resistance. So you can get off and stop watching us on your TV stations like statistics and collecting us like pictures and actually do something. Sincere resistance, so you can hold on to the bit of dignity you have left for Hadil. Thank you. You've been a fantastic, fantastic, fantastic audience. And see you tomorrow. Thanks.
Thank you so much, Dr. Rafif, for that. We're really honored to have you amongst us. I know you all want to go, but just want to remind you.